Now we come to the most glamorous part of Bharatanatyam, the Aahaarya Abhinaya, the costume and the jewelry. Let us look at a chart on the Aahaarya Abhinaya. We have scenes and settings, dresses from shells, leaves, skins, etc. Then threads and saris and patchwork. Jewelry for the ears, the arms, the waist, the anklets, necklaces, and painting colors, red, blue, etc. And of dress also. And then animals, the two-footed ones, the four-footed ones, and then the crawling animals. But we are concerned with the costume and jewelry in Bharatanatyam. The traditional jewelry worn by the temple dancers had a definite purpose and particular significance. The female form in the temples are decorated with beautiful jewelry, and maybe the inspiration was taken from them regarding the design and the way to wear them. Look at the photograph of a dancer taken about 60 years ago. You see the jewelry. It is so beautiful but also heavy to wear. Simultaneously, if you take a look at the sculpture, a female form, the decoration on her hair, it is so beautiful that at the end there seems to be a little fruit and the bird is pecking at it. It must have taken the sculptor all his imagination to produce that. Let me try and explain the significance of some of the jewels. Usually, the jewels are encrusted with rubies, emeralds, and the nine gems called the Navaratna. Number nine is said to be a mystical number corresponding to the nine planets. Now, this is so that the evil eye does not fall on the dancer. The sun and the moon, and the Talai Saman, as it is called. The grace of the sun and the moon may fall on the dancer, and the Talai Saman is to emphasize the parting. She is wearing one variety, and this child is wearing another. Then the earrings. You have the Jumki, the martel. Now, ear piercing is called Karna Vedanam, to improve the intellect, and the martel is supposed to protect the eardrum. This is the Manga Male. Just above the stomach, the chest region, to protect the heart. She is wearing one variety and she is wearing another. Then the bangles are supposed to protect the wrist, and the rings encouraging philanthropy. The nose ring, preserve chastity. The odhyanam, or the belt, of course, to protect the internal organs in the stomach, but at the same time, a straight spinal column, a good posture. And then the anklets. Of course, dancers need anklets, but this is also to give power to the ankle. Then we have beautiful decorations of the hair, jade shringara. Usually it is in jasmines or real flowers, but since they are seasonal, we have to have artificial flowers too. But let us see first the real flowers. This is the rakodi, the chudamani as it is called, and these are jasmines. This is the kunjalam. Usually we have rubies or gold here. Now, the artificial one. These are jasmine buds made of pith. these are paper flowers. We have to use them because sometimes we may not get real jasmines. Now have a look at the variety of the Jada Sringara. We usually leave it to the imagination of the artist. We use pearls and paper flowers and then what is called as chimki in red and gold. The beautiful variety of the Jada Sringara. Our discussions are incomplete if we do not pay homage to Lord Nataraja, the Lord of Dance, Shiva, whose very Ananda Tandava is the creation itself. Shivam means auspicious. Is there a poet, a philosopher, a sculptor, a painter, or a dancer who has not praised and paid homage through the word, the idea, the stone and the metal, the painting and movement? His very form brings the entire physical form on par with the spiritual state. There are various manifestations of Shiva as the supreme teacher, Dakshinamurti, the supreme beggar, Bhikshadanar, the lord of terror, Bhairava, and so on. And of course, our beloved Nataraja in the Nadanta pose. The right leg on the demon and the left leg lifted to show salvation. Now, let us share with you an unusual symbol of Shiva. That is a triangle. This is another triangle. The two triangles. This symbol is also said to be the symbol of Israel. The Star of David. The Shatkona Chakram. The six corners. Om. Nama Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. You see that? One leg lifted to show salvation and one on the demon. This is suppression of evil. Evil can never be destroyed from the universe. There is always the negative and the positive moving together. The fire in one hand to show light, also to depict destruction. The damaru, the rhythm of the universe. The abhaya hasta, this hand showing here I am, do not be afraid. The snake, a very ancient symbol, phallic symbol, said to represent maybe the breath, the life. The moon, representing intelligence, the life-giving water. The fluttering veil, maybe to show, to represent removal of ignorance. Life itself is vibrant, is cyclic, no beginning and no end. Also, the five elements, earth, water, fire, air, representing air, the breath, and ether. The rest I leave to your imagination. I am sure you could add more and more to this. Now suppose we were to superimpose the bronze and see how it fits onto this figure. This is actually a chakra. You could call it a chakra or a mudra from the tantric philosophy. Many physicists have tried to analyze this figure, which is a vibrant figure indeed. The bud that was the Alaripu blossomed into a flower in the Varnam, and the fragrance continued in the Padams and the Javanis. Should we not retain the beautiful memories of music, movement, rhythm and color? So we have such an item in the Tillana, an item of joy. It is a short and crisp dance form, one of the loveliest of musical forms and one of the most popular in dance forms. It seems to have existed even in the 16th century. The very word has the drum syllables, ti, la, na, the rhythmic syllables. And it is formed in the composition itself, as you shall see. Another idea, dil is the heart. Lahalana in Urdu is making happy. Dillana or tillana. Another word is the tarana in Hindustani. As a musical composition, it has the pallavi, anupallavi and charana. Sometimes pallavi and anupallavi or pallavi and charana. In the dance forms, the tillana uses the drum syllables. Tano tanata dirana dridridanitom pradirana dridritanom tanata dirana tanom tanata dirana. Another one. Deem nadradim deem tanana tadaradani udana deem deem tanana deem. Another very famous one. Nadradim tanadirana nadradani tom tadirana nadradim. Now I have sung for you the Pallavi alone. The reason being that the dance sequences or in the corvées, we choreograph to the Pallavi. The Anupallavi has the swara, and it is in the charana that we have the words or the sahitya, where we find the signature or the mudra of the composer. As a dance choreography, we have the meyadavu, I'm sure you know that. Then in the corvée, we have very intricate foot rhythm, and the panchanade, beautiful poses, sculptures poses, which you will see. The Tillana today will be performed by Srimati Chitra Vishveshwaram, one of the most outstanding dancers of our country. The Tillana is in Revati Raga, Aditala, and a composition of Vidwan Sri Madurayan Krishna. The Tillana will be sung by her husband, Sri Vishveshwaram, and Madurai Sethuraman. You will have the Pallavi, the Anupallavi, the Charana, and the Tillana finishes with the Swara of the Anupallavi. With the beautiful head movements, the Adami, the Sundari, then the Meyadavu, we have the Korvai. I am sure you will recognize the Adavus. We have the Panchanade, Tisram, Chatusram, Khandam, Misram, Sankirnam, 3, 4, 5, 7, and 9. The Tillana.
Dim, dim, ta-dim, dim, ta-dim, 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 ta ಸದಿ ಎಂತದಿರಲ್ಲ ಸಿಲ್ಲ ನದಿಲ್ಲ ನದಿರಲ್ಲ ದೇಂತದಿ ಎಂತದಿರಲ್ಲ ಸಿಲ್ಲ ನದಿಲ್ಲ ನದಿರಲ್ಲ ದೇಂತದಿ ದೀಂತದಿ ಎಂತದಿರಲ್ಲ ಸಿಲ್ಲ ನದಿಲ್ಲ ನದಿರಲ್ಲ ದೇಂತದಿರಲ್ಲ
ಪಣಿಂದಿರು ಎಂಗೂ ನಿರೈಂದ ಪ್ರಣವ ಸ್ವರೂಪಿಣಿ ತಾಯೇ ಭುವನೇಶ್ವರಿ ಪೊಂಗೂ ಮಂಗಳಂ ತಂದಿಡು ದೇವಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣದಾಸಂ ಪಣಿಂದಿಡು ಎಂಗೂ ನಿರೈಂದ ಪ್ರಣವ ಸ್ವರೂಪಿಣಿ ತಾಯೇ ಭುವನೇಶ್ವರಿ ಪೊಂಗೂ ಮಂಗಳಂ ತಂದಿಡು
on more positive ground as regards the appreciation of Bharatanatyam. I hope I have tried to create at least an interest in the dance, if not the love of the art. I may have made a slip here and there unintentionally. Do forgive us. We began with the importance of dance to man, and we saw several charts beginning with the selective and probable evolution of dance in the world. the chart on the adavus, then the bhava, and so on. You saw the adavus, the basic dance units, forming chorus or dance sequences, and then we went to the alaripu. And then we wound our way discussing various subjects, hastas, hand gestures, the movements of the neck, and then the abhinaya. And you met very eminent people who shared with us their views, which were very valuable to us. So you have seen Bharatanatyam in the different branches of nritya, dritya, and abhinaya. There are many things I have not been able to touch upon, but still do forgive us. It seems once Buddha was preaching under a peepal tree. One of his disciples got up and asked, "Master, you have expounded the theory of karma and dharma. Tell us what happens to the soul and life after death." Buddha looked up, plucked a few leaves, showed it to his disciple and said, "What I have told you is this, but what you have to learn is the entire tree. What I have told you is only a tiny drop in the ocean of the great art of Bharatanatyam." A Sanskrit line comes to my mind: "Mahimanam yat utkirtya maya samhriyate vachah shramena tat ashaktaya va na gunanam yattaya." The meaning of those lines: I am concluding the greatness of the art I was explaining because I am beginning to show fatigue. I am unable to explain further in my limited capacity its greatness, which is unlimited. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.